I may have accidentally influenced the Fallout show on Amazon Prime. And before you tell me to take off the tinfoil hat and lay off the jet, let me explain. The Fallout show just recently came out on Amazon Prime, and it's already safe to say that it's the best video game adaptation of all time. While this is the first official TV show, there's also a variety of fan films and web series. I'm Mike Natoli. I'm the writer, director, and editor of Mojave Blues, a Fallout New Vegas web series streaming on YouTube since 2019. About 6 years ago, when I was a senior in college, a few close friends and cosplayers of mine made the first episode of Mojave Blues as a project for Montclair State University's TV program. Even though we only had $2,000 and a dream, everybody who worked on it absolutely loved the Fallout series, and we tried to jam-pack as much as we possibly could into it. For the NCR, the Rangers, Courier 6, Veronica, the Brotherhood of Steel, Volpe's Inculta, Boone even had a little cameo. All of these familiar faces in an original story that had never been told so far in the game universe. I'm not going to spoil it, go check it out for yourself. A few months after the series finale of Mojave Blues premiered, Amazon announced that they were going to make an official Fallout TV show. This was around the same time I was interviewing for a video editing job at Bethesda Studios. I got to the final round and ended up interviewing with the two directors of marketing for Bethesda Studios. Long story short, I completely botched the interview. Little 21-year-old me was really nervous. But about that interview, I noticed they were asking me pointed questions about how my team and I were able to accomplish Mojave Blues. Specifically, how did you find so many abandoned locations? How did you get this many people involved with literally no budget? How were you able to write an original story around this? I mean, I answered honestly, in South Jersey, there is a ton of abandoned filming locations in the Pine Barrens. But fast forward 4 to 5 years later, and I see a couple similarities. Just a few. First off, it appears that somebody out there may have taken my advice, because they ended up shooting in the Pine Barrens, 45 minutes away from where Mojave Blues was shot. If my series or my team had any impact on the Fallout series whatsoever, I just want to say I'm grateful. It's not much, but it's enough to make me wonder. I'm not looking for money, I'm not looking for fame, I'm not gonna claim I am Vault-Tec! Even if this conspiracy theory is true or not, I just want to say I'm grateful that Bethesda actually listens to the fans. So go check it out, it's worth the watch, and don't forget to watch Mojave Blues on YouTube, and let me know what you think.